As Dean described, we should let the data speak to determine variables of interest. There's a tool that we can use to create a number of scatterplots automatically. It's called a scatterplot matrix. In a scatterplot matrix, there's a grid of scatterplots between every pair of variables. As we've seen, scatterplots are great, but not necessarily suited for all types of variables, for example, categorical ones. So there are other types of visualizations that can be created instead of scatterplots, like box plots or histograms, when the variables are categorical. Let's produce the scatterplot matrix for our pseudo Facebook dataset. We're going to use the ggally package to do so, so make sure you've installed it, and then go ahead and load it using the library command. Now I'm also going to set the theme here too. Now there's two other things that we want to do. First, we want to set the seed so we get reproducible results. Now you might be wondering why we set the seed in the first place, and it's because we're going to sample from our dataset. Our dataset contains all of these variables, and I actually don't want all the variables. I don't want user ID, year joined, or year joined.bucket. So what I can do is subset my data frame and then sample from that subset. If I check out the variables in my subset data frame, these are the ones of interest. Now, I didn't use year joined or year joined.bucket because this one's a categorical variable, and really these were derived from tenure. Now I'm ready to use the ggpairs function inside of ggally to create this scatterplot matrix. Now, I've already run this piece of code, and I do want to warn you that it takes a long time for this to generate. It might even take over an hour. Feel free to run the command, and if it's taking a long time for your plot to generate, just come back to your computer at another time. We've also included a PDF of the scatterplot in the instructor notes, so you can check that out as well. Here's our scatterplot matrix. And notice in the upper part of the matrix, we can see the correlation coefficients for the pairs of variables. For age and date of birth year, the correlation is actually -1, and we can see that on the scatterplot. Sometimes we may want to produce these types of matrices, so that way we can produce one-number summaries of the different relationships of our variables. This is just like the correlation work that we did in lesson 4. So I've described the plots above the diagonal for the scatterplot matrix, but what do you notice in the lower left of the scatterplot matrix? Write a few sentences about what you see in this next quiz, and pay careful attention to the variable of gender. What types of plots do you think these are?